I'll be reading John. I'll be reading John 3:16 through 18 as our scripture. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he hath not believed in the name of the only begotten Son. Now we'll be having the Bread of Life from Pastor Terrell C. Trent from Dwelling Place Ministries.
Amen, amen, amen. Y'all, we have some technical difficulties. I mean, the devil is busy, but God is busy, amen. I mean, we had everything situated. We had the computer situated. We had the microphone situated. And now everything's not working, but guess what? The word is still going to go forward, amen? The word is still going to go forward because there is a word from the Lord. I can't worry about no microphones. I can't worry about this. But God is still good, amen? Amen. If you have no Bibles, while we return to Acts, the 28th chapter, amen, verses 1 through 6. I mean, y'all, we had everything together. We had everything together. And then just, the devil's busy, but, you know, God still get the glory. He still get the honor, regardless. But I'm not worried about it because it just, It's going to be all right. It's going to be all right. Amen. If we have it, will you please say, I got it. Amen. God is still good. He is still good. And it reads, and when they were escaped, then they knew that the island was called Melita. Verse 2 says, and the barbarous people showed us no little kindness, for they came not far and received us every one. Because of the present rain and because of the cold, and when Paul had gathered a bundle of sticks and laid them on the fire, there came a viper of the heat and fastened on his hand. Verse 4 says, and when the barbarians saw the venomous beast hang on his hand, they said among themselves, no doubt. Someone say, no doubt.
No doubt.
This man is a murderer, whom though he had escaped the sea, yet vengeance suffered not to live. Verse 5 says, and he shook off the beast into the fire and felt no harm. Someone say, no harm.
No harm.
Howbeit they looked when he should have swollen or fallen down dead suddenly, but after that have looked a great while and saw no harm come to him, they changed their minds and said that he was a god. Amen. Thank God for the word on today. If I had a subject on today, it would be I felt it, but it didn't take me out. Can somebody put that on the chat? On Facebook today, I felt it. Someone say, I felt it, but it didn't take me out. Amen. My brothers and sisters, Paul were on this way, on his way to Rome to stand trial before Caesar. Amen. Paul, along with the others, are on the island of Melita as a result of a shipwreck. They are wet, they are cold, and to make matters worse, it's raining. Amen? The Bible says that Paul gathered sticks to place on the fire, but to his surprise, there was a snake hiding in the pile. My brothers and sisters, one thing I have discovered about people who have a snake mentality is that they often hide behind things and will show up when you least expect them. Yes, they camouflage themselves behind love, and then they, what? They strike, amen? They camouflage themselves behind the pulpit. They camouflage behind the crop rolls, behind the pews and deacon boys. They even strike us like family and friends. And when you're least expected, and don't pay attention, is when they strike. So as we look at this lifestyle of Paul, the one who was known first of all as a persecutor. He was known as a serial killer. He was also known for killing Christians. But as he is on his way near the Damascus Road, some of us know the story. How God knocked him down off his high horse. Sometimes, y'all, God got to knock us down off our high horse sometimes. And when he got up, he was blind. And at this point, he asked the Lord, what would you have me to do? And the Lord told him, go. Someone said, go. That's a word for somebody this morning. You have been dealing with turmoil in your life, and the devil has been running rampage in your life, but now the Lord has gotten your attention, and he's telling you to go. And I'm here to tell somebody this evening that we have to get in a hurry because time is winding up. Amen? My brothers and sisters, we should not be surprised by the fact that the people are going to talk about us. People are going to talk about us. And even mistreat us from time to time because it is in their nature. And if it's on the inside of them, it's bound to come out. Luke 6 and 45 says, for of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh, amen. I have said on several occasions that if people cannot find something on you, they will make something up, amen. I just want to drop this on you. We don't have to be what folks say we are. Amen. How many folks have fallen out of church because of something somebody said? Huh? But look, Paul did not give into the snake. He did not even try to get back at the snake for biting him. He just shook it off. Someone says, shake it off. Shake. My brothers and sisters, when people make it their point to attack us, we do not need to get back at them. We need to just learn how to shake it off. Amen. Romans, the 12th chapter, and the 17th through the 19th verse says, do not repay evil for evil. Be careful to do what is right in the eyes of everyone. 18 says, if it is possible, as far as it depends on, live at peace with everyone. I know sometimes, y'all, it's hard to live peace with everybody, but sometimes the Bible says we have to. Do not take revenge, my dear friends, but leave room for God's wrath. For it is written, it is mine to avenge, I will repay, says the Lord. Don't try to get back by people. You know, we have to learn how to pray for folks, amen, and move forward. Now let us read verse 6. This verse 6 says, howbeit they looked when he should have swollen or fallen down dead suddenly. But after they had looked a great while and saw no harm come to him, they changed their minds and said he was a god. Paul should have gotten sick. He should have died, but my brothers and sisters, when God is your refuge and when God is your strength, when God is your protection, the very thing that should have hurt you, the very thing should have taken you out, will not do you no harm. Amen? Paul just shook it off and he kept going. Amen? That counselor should have killed you. God had another plan, amen? That attack should drove you crazy and insane, but God had another plan. That drug overdose should have wiped you out, but God had another plan. Someone put, God had another plan. People say that you have committed suicide right now, but God had another plan. People said that you could have lost your mind a long time ago, but God had another plan. That car wreck should have killed you, but God had another plan. The question is, have you ever seen the hand of God interrupt an obvious attack on your life? That decision was supposed to be disastrous. That mission was supposed to be a mess. Your career was supposed to be over. That crisis, that calamity, that sudden heartbreak was supposed to take you out. You are in a strange place, but God will change some stuff in your life. What should be the response when God suspends, retains stuff out your life? Amen. Look at Apostle Paul. Instead of tripping, guess what he did? He kept on serving. He is throwing sticks on the fire in the rain because Paul realized that there are times in your life that you are going to keep the fire going in the midst of the bad weather. Yes, people are going to talk. Let them talk. Keep the fire going. People are going to have negative thoughts about you. Guess what? Keep the fire going. Somebody say, keep the fire going. Don't let the fire go out. Don't let your praise go out because you're worried about folks. Sometimes y'all folks going to be your worst enemy. Don't miss your blessing worrying about folks. Don't miss your breakthrough worrying about folks. There are times when things will be a stream. It'll be times when things will get bad. But don't lose focus. Amen?
Amen.
Keep on pushing. There are times God called us to keep the fire going in pouring rain. Pastor, what you mean by that? Days, it's going to be days when you don't feel like rejoicing. It's going to be days when you feel like, not even feel like saying amen. It's going to be days when you feel like, don't even feel like visiting the city. It's going to be days when you don't feel like praying for others. But you must keep the fire going. Somebody say, keep the fire going. I believe that we must be getting close because sometimes we are in a painful place. Because Paul was in a painful place. He was shipwrecked. And then now all of a sudden he getting bit by a snake. He was in a painful situation. Paul is throwing sticks on the fire. He is throwing wood into the fire. The Bible says a snake jumps out of the fire and bites Paul on his hand. Amen. Have you ever seen trouble that just won't leave? Have you seen trouble just don't want to let go of you? that holds on to you. The snake bites Paul and then it will not let him go. Depression bites you and it won't let you go. Hard times and discouragement will bite you and it won't let you go. Amen? But guess what we have to do? We have to hold on to our faith. I have seen the enemy attack many in my lifetime, but the only thing we need to do when the enemy holds us is hold on to your faith. I'm going to say hold on to your faith. Days when you don't know how to feel, hold on to your faith. Amen? These people was waiting for Paul to drop dead. These people was waiting for him to drop dead. Do you know that there are some people want to see you fall? There are some people do not want to see you succeed and be happy. They will smile and plot in your face and talk about you at the same time. But thanks be to God, God will change that situation around. Amen? So whatever that is biting you on today, learn how to shake it off. It may be your past relationships. It may be your past hurt, your past friendship. Learn how to shake it off and keep going. So I run a chat, keep going. Just like Paul, he didn't let the snake bite affect him. He didn't let it affect him. He still praised God regardless. He still moved toward like nothing bothered him. We got to be like Paul on today. Even though you slay me, even though you talk about me, even though you mistreat me, I'm going to still move forward. How many know God been too good for us? God been too good to us for us to dwell on the bite. You may feel the pain. Yeah, you may feel the pain, the heartache, the sleepless night. But guess what? Shake it off and keep it moving. Yes, yes, yes. That very thing that you thought was going to take me out. Guess what? It didn't work. The enemy thought he has you by your coattail. But we serve the enemy notice today that I felt it. But it didn't take me out. Hallelujah. No longer will I have my head down. It didn't take me out. No longer will I look defeated. It didn't take me out. Because greater is he than is in the world. Amen. No longer will I cry tears of sorrow. Because it didn't take me out. I'm still standing. I'm still holding on to God's word. I'm still believing. I know it's coming. I can see. I can feel it. You may thought you run, devil, but the poison is venom. But guess what? It didn't kill me because it just made me stronger. It made me wiser. When I look back on how far God brought me, some past relationships should have took me out. Some past hurts should have took me out. Some sleepless nights should have took me out. But I serve the devil notice tonight that Jesus came and grabbed me. Amen. Jesus, the man who died for me. Jesus, the man who set me free. The one they spit on. The one that they lied on. The one that hung on the cross. Jesus, the one who was beat on just for me. Yes, God, every spit was for me. Every hit was for me. Every whip was for me. But guess what? He rose with all power. Hallelujah. The Bible says, oh, death, where is your sting? Oh, hallelujah. I felt the attack. I felt the heartache. I felt the abuse. But glory be to God. It didn't take me out. Don't worry about what the enemy say. Don't worry about what the snake do to you. Guess what? You move forward. God bless you.
I'm surrounded by you. This is how I fight my battles. how I fight my battles. This is 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 how I fight my battles.
Man, look.
It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you.
Man, the song says, it may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. Thank you, Jesus. It's good when you got Jesus on your side, amen?
Amen.
It's good when you got somebody like Jesus on your side. Thank you, Jesus. We're going to do our mission statement on today. This is Dwelling Place Mission Statement. We're going to read together. To make true believers out of unbelievers and make true disciples out of believers. And to equip them with the word of God so they can stand against the devil's schemes. This is our vision statement for Dwelling Place. To focus on the people and their needs, accept them as they are, and share the gospel by living
lives.
Beware to share our faith as opportunities to serve others. Support each other through the word of God. And that's the key, y'all. We got to support each other. Through the word of God. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So we thank everyone who has been sowing in the ministry. We thank everyone who has been praying for us. And like I said, we're still young in the ministry, but guess what? God is still good. He is worthy. Amen. Thank y'all for your love, your support, your prayers. I mean, everything. Thank you. It's much needed, amen, because the devil is busy. You know, we're young, and the devil, look at that.
The devil's not going to stop us.
The devil won't stop us, amen. He can't stop us. We are here to advance the kingdom, and guess what? It's time to get busy, amen.
Amen.
God is good. Like I said, our cash app is $Dwelling Place 2021. Again, cash app is $Dwelling Place 2021. God is good. God is doing something for Dwelling Place. It don't matter what man say. It don't matter what people say. The only thing that matters is what God say. So Dwelling Place is moving forward, amen. We can't worry about what people say. We can't worry about what the enemy say, because guess what? God get the glory. And it kind of hurt my feelings a little, because everything wasn't working right, and I'm frustrated. But guess what?
Just keep moving forward.
Yeah, keep moving forward. Because all this going to pass away. All this technology stuff going to pass away. But guess what? God's word is still going to stay. Amen?
Amen.
It's only going to stay. I love you all. Thank God for each one of y'all for tuning in. Please share this word, amen. Starting next Friday, we will start doing Facebook Live, but gonna be Friday Night Live, amen. And we're not doing no preaching or nothing, but we're gonna be doing songs and worship songs, and we're gonna just go higher in the Lord, amen. Because how many people know that we need more word just on Sunday? We need word on Monday, Tuesday. We need word every day. So starting next Friday, we'll be going live. Amen. Friday Night Live. Someone say Friday Night Live.
Friday Night Live.
Next Friday. So we'll be doing worship songs, and we're just going to go higher in the Lord. Amen. In September, we are doing a revival, amen? We're doing a revival September. I think it's the second week of September. It's for 7 days, amen? I'm trying to get everything together now, all the speakers and whatever. I'm getting everything together now. This will be our first revival. The six days, it will be on Facebook Live, but after the other 2 days, it would be in Dyer County Central, in Dyersburg, Tennessee. It'll be in Dyer County Central that Friday and that Saturday. But the other days, Sunday through Thursday, it will be at, on Facebook Live. So I pray everybody will be blessed on that. I will keep everybody posted. But pray for us. Pray for my wife. Continue to pray that we go stronger in God's word. Amen. Amen. I love you all, and thank God for you all.